Well, good morning, this is Sam in Wyoming, and I thought I would just take a little bit of time to let you know what I've been working on lately. In May and in June, I'm going to be doing quite a bit of traveling. Next week, I'm going to the Utah Woodturning Symposium that I go to every year, and I really look forward to that. It's a great symposium. If you're down there, look me up and say hi. In June, I'm going to be doing a little traveling. I'm going to see some granddaughters, and also I'm going to Kansas City for the AAW Woodturning Symposium. And also, if you're down there and you see me, look me up and say hi. I'll be doing two demonstrations on thread chasing. Now, I want to just show you what I've been working on. For me, doing videos and working in my shop is a little bit of a balance, you know, between videotaping everything I do and shutting the camera off and actually doing some work. So I'm trying to do both. Anyway, this is a piece. This is a hollow form I've been working on, and I want to take this to Utah for the Instant Gallery. I've got this dyed with some blue and brown. I really like that combination. I've got the opening threaded, and I've got the beginnings of what's going to be the base for my finial turned, and I just need to turn that down, turn a finial, finish off the bottom. I still got that nub on there, and then that'll be complete. I've got probably four or five coats of sealer on this, mostly shellac, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I may put an oil on that. That will be determined. Let me show you some other items I've been working on. Okay, here's another colored box elder piece that I've been working on. I have a finial that just sits in there. It's not threaded. I really don't do that very often, but just thought I'd try that. And I've got that dyed blue. I have a little bit of sanding there on the bottom of that, and that'll be completed. I probably have 10 or 12 coats of either a sealer and then a lacquer. And I just need to buff that a little bit. The spray came out very nicely. I don't have a lot of imperfections on that, so it won't take much work to get that completed. And I'm going to take that to Utah as well. And I'm very happy with that. Little blue dye, and then that's about all. And what's showing through there is the burl figure. Now this is another urn that I've been working on, and I'm not sure if you've seen this. Maybe when I was making it. I've got a Mopani finial. It's a little bit non-traditional. That's also threaded into the top of that. So when I'm threading that in there, I start with an insert, and then around that I put another piece of wood that's usually black wood that serves as the base for my finial. I can thread that in there. The base of this is some of that metal reactive paint. And it's always fun to do that. It's always fun to mess around with that metal reactive paint. Now, if you're familiar with More Wood Turning, the online magazine, I've got an article in there from last month's issue on doing this metal reactive paint. It must be the April issue, but you can look that up, More Wood Turning magazine, and they got some really cool stuff in there. So let me show you what else I've got. Now last fall at the Rocky Mountain Wood Turning Symposium, someone had this piece of wood for sale. It's a piece of Jarrah burl, and that grows in Australia. And I had the opportunity to purchase this, and I couldn't pass it up. So that can be displayed flat, and it's kind of a wobble bowl, if you will, but I think it's better displayed in a stand. And I think that's pretty cool. You may never get another chance to have a piece of Jarrah. So there's something else I've been working on, and that's finished. Let me show you something else. Now, in the midst of everything else, I've been turning some pens. And this is a pen out of some Banksia seed pod. Turned out pretty cool. These are some pieces I've colored and stabilized. And you'll probably see more videos, at least related a little bit to doing some pressure casting with resin and also some stabilizing with some color. I'm still experimenting with that. These pen blanks up here have been sitting around for a couple years, and I finally took them out of the box. They're very dry. It's all box elder. And what I like to do with these is color them. And I'll put an inset up here of some pens I turned. I'll put a picture up here, and you can take a look at some of those. All right, now what you're looking at here are going to be a couple more videos. This is a mallet that I've been turning. It's finished, and there'll be a video on that. That's for my fro. I needed a new mallet or persuader, so that video's in the works. And I was also commissioned by a lady to turn a rolling pin. Now, this particular rolling pin is still in the clamps. I had to glue it up because it's rather large. And this one's going to have roller bearings in the ends where the handles go. So bring that a little bit. It's going to be fairly large. Get that in the shot there. Well, so I've been busy, and I'm going to shut my camera off now and go back to work. Take this nice clean shirt off. And I hope to see you in Utah or maybe Kansas City. Thank you very much for watching, and I got to go to work on some videos.